Let's assume that Golden Week is Goku versus Ma Junior. Dokkan, you might want to get your notepads out because we're taking a look at a fan-made Goku from that arc. The arc that seems to be what is going to be Golden Week. Let's get right into it. Straight away, in the arc you can see there that Goku is headbutting Piccolo. So we'll start off with the art. The art looks nice, I'll be fair. The art looks nice. The art is animated though, so I'm guessing this is an LR. It is indeed. One thing that I'll say right away is that Golden Week is unlikely to be an LR this year. Maybe next year, maybe the year after. But for this year, I've got a feeling that it's gonna stay. It's gonna be a TUR. But we'll have to wait and see what they do. Let's start off with the leader skill. Battle of Fate and Turtle School. I'll be honest, that's a very, very decent leader skill. Because you get a Battle of Fate, and then you basically get every Goku. So not bad at all. And then for the extra 30%, it's Bond of Friendship. I'm not exactly sure what units are on that team. But this could be really good. I don't know, I'll be honest. But there's certainly a lot of potential with the first two leader skills there. So I'll give you that. Okay, so for the 12th key, he's raising attack and defense. So that's a 30% increase for one turn. And then he also greatly lowers enemies' attack and defense. Okay, not bad. And then for the 18 key, he greatly raises attack and defense. So, wait, that's a guaranteed stun? It's not even a chance to stun. It's a guaranteed stun. And then he's stacking defense. Because yeah, for 99 turns, yeah, so he's stacking defense permanently. Okay, not bad at all. So he's stacking defense by 50% on the Ultra Super. Very, very good so far. And then he's got the entrance animation, but this only activates for one turn. So for that one turn, he's getting attack and defense plus 159%. It's only one turn though, so it's not that big of a deal. But turn one, I'm guessing this guy will be our monster, which is definitely very important. So I'll give you that, or I'll give the unit that. Plus an additional attack and defense, plus 59% when performing a super attack. So that's for the 12 key. If you get the 12 key super, he'll get that active. But if it's an ultra super, it's going to be 100% attack and defense. So it says all this. So only one of these will activate. They won't stack, is what I'm guessing this means. So honestly, what happened there? Go back. There we are. So 100% attack and defense when performing a super attack. And then he creates STR orbs. I would rather that be rainbow orbs, but I guess I'll take STR orbs, can't complain. And then he's got a great chance to disable action once within the turn. That's actually a pretty powerful ability, I won't lie. That's pretty powerful. But for the units that build up after they get hit, that will definitely negatively impact them. And the reason I bring that up is because right now there's a lot of units in Dokkan that need to get hit to build up, so that would definitely hinder that. But overall, the ability is really powerful. And then he's got a guaranteed additional, wait, that doesn't say super. I'm gonna assume you mean super here. I'm gonna assume this is a guaranteed additional super with 3 or more key spheres obtained. It doesn't clarify here, but I'm gonna assume that it is a super attack. And that's actually really good, because it's only 3 orbs, and not to mention he creates STR orbs, so that will be very, very easy to do. Just basically a free guaranteed additional, and then launches an additional super. Actually, wait, why do you specify additional attack here, but then here you specify super attack? Honestly, I don't care what he's saying, I'm gonna assume that he is saying if you get 5 orbs, you get 2 guaranteed additional supers. And that is really powerful. Just give this guy a bit of extra defensive utility. Give him guard, damage reduction or dodge. And this unit is looking really, really good. Let's continue reading over here. Key plus 2 per STR key sphere obtained. Okay, but don't forget he's creating STR orbs. So that is really, really good. And then he revives with 80% HP when the character or an attacking ally is KO'd in the same turn. So that revive is basically for free. Whenever you die, turn 1, turn 77, turn 69, it doesn't matter. if you die and this guy is on rotation, you get a free revive. Honestly, fair enough. The only issue with that is, this won't age well. And the reason it won't age well is because the more units that get revived, the less effective it becomes. Because you can only revive once. And this unit in particular, from what I can see here, over here, yeah, he gets stronger with the revive, so he has to revive. But if another unit revives, this guy cannot revive. And if he cannot revive, he's not that impressive. But if he can revive, he's really good. Because then if you revive, he gets an extra key plus 6, attack and defense plus 59%, and damage reduction by 59% for the rest of the battle. This unit is genuinely the best unit in the game. He's got the leader skill to back it up. He's got all of that. Very, very powerful unit. What's the links at over here? But the link's bad, so it doesn't matter. Shocking speed? It's not bad. Legendary power, as expected, it's an LR. Infighter, shattering the limit. Give him prepared for battle there. Why are you giving him that? Give him fierce battle. What? World tournament champion and all in the family. His link set on a scale of 1 to 10, I would honestly give it a 3.5 out of 10. It's really, maybe a 4, but the point is the link set is trash. The link set is trash. It's not the worst link set I've ever seen, but it's really not that impressive. What teams is he on? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 teams. So it's a decent amount of teams. He's on Bond of Parent and Child. He's got some powerful teams there. Goku family, Pure Saiyans, okay. He's on Physical God Goku's team, which is always really good. And what are... Those stats are literally too high. Mate, take away 10,000 defense there, and take away 10,000 attack, and he's still like the best unit in the game. Obviously, that would be low stats for an LR, but even if you did that, this is still the best unit in the game. With those stats, it's too much. It's actually too much. So make the stats realistic, and this unit is like the best unit in the game. With that, he's way too good. But make those stats realistic, and he's still the best unit in the game by a decent margin. I would actually go as far as to say that. But like I said, it's unlikely to be an LR, and honestly, Goku versus Bar Jr. isn't even confirmed yet. There's a 99% chance that it's going to be this, but it might not be this. Honestly, I think I'm personally hoping that it ends up being Majin Buu Saga related. And we get a Super Saiyan 2 Gohan from the World Tournament. I would definitely be hyped for that. Because Gohan in that outfit in the Majin Buu Saga, for me, I really want a unit to represent that in Dokkan. I would definitely be hyped for that. And depending on how good it is, and depending on the banner, I would definitely summon for that. Let's do a quick subscriber challenge. If you guys agree with me that this unit over here, this fan-made unit, if we get exactly this, this would be the best unit in the game, then you have to subscribe, because that is the challenge. With that said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, then do subscribe, especially if you just failed that challenge, because that is the challenge. Also, do leave a like and comment, because those things do help out. With that said, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.